Today's video is about understanding Pereskia, the original cacti. You're looking at some Pereskia aculeata growing in my greenhouse. It tends to grow somewhat like a vine if you let it. I am Winston in London. Welcome to my channel. Some people find it difficult to appreciate the cacti in Pereskia. Let's look at some young samples of aculeata. The first one you notice is very green and just shows a few spines, so much so that you can be deceived in thinking that it's not really a cactus. Let's look at another example of aculeata. Notice the way the back of the leaves turn purple. Aculeata has this tendency to change into different shapes, sizes, and even color. Look at this. This is Gotsefiana. Always very beautiful, always very colorful. But to appreciate the cactus in aculeata, you have to look at older plants. For the next minute, I'll show you an older version of aculeata and look at the spines. All cactus have areoles, and that's the growing tip of the plant. That tip always shows you lots of spine and produces the leaves, the flowers, and any kind of activity. Look at this very carefully. Look at the way as it gets older, the leaves disappear, leaving a junction box, which we call areoles. At the lower end of the plant, you hardly notice leaves. Most of the leaves of this aculeata are way up to the top of the plant, and therefore you can hardly see them. Areoles are important for cactus. It's the distinguishing factor that makes them cactus. These plants are cactus before evolution and mutation. That's why they look so different from your average opuntia. They fulfill all the conditions that a cactus needs. And sometimes they can be just as beautiful in blooms and in fruits. We'll see some fruits and flowers now. The flowers tend to vary depending on the variety of plant. Some are creamy white, some are just creamy, and others are more yellow in color. Whatever color, I find them very attractive. But I should add, it's difficult for them to survive in the autumn when they bloom because of our climate. Some people ask me, are the fruits worth eating? Some people do eat them. I've tasted them. I find them a bit sour. I believe that if you're lost on an island and have nothing to eat, Pereskia fruits would do. But on the other hand, I'll stick to my regular fruits if I'm in the normal market. I recommend you try and grow some of these plants. Pereskia are very challenging since they come from the tropics and South America. They need protection from cold. I grow them here in London. Not always easy, but very successfully. Have a go yourself. You should enjoy it.